श्री एवी स्वामी।
थैंक यू सर। ऑन दिस ओकेजन आई रिमेंबर डॉक्टर राम मोहन लोहिया वार्निंग दैट एनी न्यू गवर्नमेंट दैट फेल टू ब्रिंग अबाउट विजिबल चेंजेस टू मीट द एस्पिरेशंस ऑफ द पीपल मोर इम्पॉर्टेंटली पुअर इन द फर्स्ट 100 डेज of its taking over would lose their credibility and trust of the people. We have assembled here after 50 days of the new government under our forward-looking Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi to give shape to his inspiring dream of Ek Bharat, Shrestha Bharat. We in Odisha are waiting for this performance. Sri Vallabhbhai Patel, the Iron Man of India, had admirably united fractured Bharat left over by the British by wiping out umpteen number of princely states, the Nizamuddins, and archaic segregated administrative units into a great nation. The politically united Bharat is again fractured into India and Bharat, where India is making strides in economic development and other spheres at the cost of Bharat that is struggling for survival. The PPP mode and the FDI of resource mobilization is frighteningly meant for the rich, and it will not be including Bharat in its agenda. Narendra Modi has often and rightly reiterated railways play an important role in economic development and social transformation. I give example of Odisha, better known as the land of Lord Jagannath elsewhere and abroad, how neglect of railways has done havoc to keep the state poor and isolated despite vast richness of mineral and natural resources. Odisha has mineral resources such as manganese, bauxite, and other major minerals and account for 35% of national iron ore resources and 24% of coal reserves, for which the rail happens to be the most economic and efficient mode of transportation. Odisha's railway density is 14.6 and so low compared to the adjoining states like Bihar, 39.90, Jharkhand, 35.30, and West Bengal, three times Odisha's at 43.40, sir. East Coast Railways earns 14,000 crores from Odisha and leaves a surplus of net balance of 7,700 crores for reinvestment in railways. But the allocation of railway made during 1913-14 to Odisha on our request is only 846 crores, which is not even 10% of the earnings from this region. This year, our Honorable Railway Minister, may please note, this year, as against the government of Orissa's request for 3,160 crores, we got hardly 1,420 crores. This means money earned from poor state like Orissa, which has been struggling to get the status of special status, is special category treatment is being siphoned out to other comparatively developed states. 7 out of 30 districts, I come from that area, sir, Please, to other people who have been referring to the poor, please give me time to tell about that area from where I am coming and what has led to the neglect of railways in this region. 7 out of 30 districts do not have any railway line. Of these, two, namely Nawarangpur and Malkangiri, fall in the infamously named KBK district. I was born in Nawarangpur, one of the part of the KVK district, now a district headquarters, and wrote essays as a student in school on railways without ever having seen a railway. Today, without having had a sight of railways, my grandchildren are also writing essays. But this time, Mr. Railway, Honorable Railway Minister, they will be writing essays on bullet trains, metros, and that type of neglect has been done to Orissa. What has been the result of this? I have suffered. I am struggling to persuade every corner to see that that part of Orissa is not neglected. What has been the ultimate this one? The absence of railway commission. Communication in this region has hindered not only growth, but also promoted extreme poverty. This has made these bordering districts, with Chhattisgarh in the west, Andhra Pradesh in the south, the capital of Naxalism in the country, that is KBK district, Koraput, and Kalahandi, and
Swamiji,
this is emerged as a center.
Swamiji,
further, sir.
Please.
This has emerged as a
of time.
Capital. Please. This is not something which I am quoting from newspaper clippings. This is experience. This particular area is not only backward, it has emerged as a center of slave trade of migrant labor that you must have seen in the newspaper. Sir, lastly, I would like to say one more thing. The railway project that have significant as well connectivity between comparatively developed coastal areas and underdeveloped West Orissa are also being ignored. One such example is Khurda Balangir rail project, for which the state government has committed to allocate land and share 50% of the construction cost for this event, has not received any priority till today. Similar is the fate of Titlagar, Vimlagar, Bargar, Nawapada, via Padmpur, that would have created new and alternative corridor for movement of coal and minerals. It is shocking, sir. Last but not least, it is shocking that despite so many railway projects sanctioned elsewhere in the new budget, this particular region is completely ignored.
So you make
Sri Navin Patnaik, let me warn the House. Let me warn the House. This neglect we may not be able to tolerate any longer. Sri Navin Patnaik, Chief Minister of Orissa, with an unprecedented mandate of 117 MLAs in a House of 147, 20 out of 21 seats in the Lok Sabha, 8
Thank
out
you.
Of 10 Rajya
so
Sabha members,
conclude.
Is an admirably strong
I'm
position
to call another
politically
speaker.
In the country.
Please conclude.
Please, 1 minute more, 1 minute more, because I would like to warn. I am not a politician. I am not a politician. I don't belong to any political order. I am a social worker, born and brought up in this area. And therefore, this is a final warning. He is in an admirably position, political strength in the country. He is also a great dreamer, committed to turn Odisha into ruler of Germany by tapping the vast natural resources. Given this scenario, perpetuation of neglect of Odisha might anger the Odias, who may rise in revolt. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Shri Bhubaneshwar Kalita. Kalita ji.
Thank you.
The budget, rail budget of 2014-15 is praised by section as the unique budget because it has the highest ever allocation outlay of rupees 65,455 crore. Sir, I may mention here that it is just 1.8% higher than rupees 64,305 crore announced in the interim budget presented by the railway minister in UPA 2 ministers. So this is nothing much to be unique because it is only 1.8% raise in the outlay. Sir, this budget is more cosmetic and it is more of a repackaged one. Many aspects of the railway budget are repackaged versions of UPA government, which had already initiated. Issues like improving computerization of passenger reservation system was already carried out by UPA government. The government has taken credit for Jammu-Udhampur-Katra railway line, but is that built in 1 month of NDA government? No, sir. It was started long back. So taking credit of this Jammu-Udhampur and Katra railway line is again nothing but its repackage or cosmetic claim that has been made by the railway minister. The railway minister again proposes future e-ticketing to support 7,200 tickets per minute and to allow 1.2 lakh simultaneous users. This was already proposed and partly implemented during UPA government. Wi-Fi on trains already implemented in the proposed UPA. In Calcutta Rajdhani Rail, Rajdhani, it has already Wi-Fi facilities. The name of Rail Ahar, which was there already, has been renamed as food courts. Again, the proposed train of Swami Vivekananda, the UPA has already running Swami Vivekananda Express, announced in 2012, four trains named Vivek Express. One is the longest, one from Dibrugarh, Assam to Kanyakumari, longest rail in India and ninth longest in the world. So these announcements were already, these were already there. So it is only repackaged in this railway budget. Sir, we all know that railway is the lifeline of the nation, lifeline of the people of India. But railway still remains the primary mode of transport for the poor. And this country, and is likely to remain so for decades to come. It would be unfair for the poor to bear the entire cost of transport, and government has to provide subsidy. Because if we think by introducing bullet trains, which the minister has said in his speech, that it is the wish and dream of every Indian that India runs bullet train as early as possible. Mr. Minister, bullet train is not the dream of common people of India. It is not the wish of common people of India. Because the fare that will be charged in the bullet train will not be affordable to the common man. So when you say it is the wish and dream of every Indian that India runs bullet train as early as possible, I think I respectfully differ with you. Sir, the Indian Rail is a continuing process over the years. We have seen the oldest Indian railway line in my region, in northeastern region. So railway has developed over the years. So to say that a government which is only over a month old government revolutionizing the entire railway is a bit undigestible. So the proposed development that has been made, proposed in this budget, we must remember that how did the railway minister start? The railway minister made a fair hike of over 14% in the railway fare. Although in this budget there is no hike in railway fare or railway freight, but it has been done already just before the budget, which is not done, which is not proper. But even then, with that, what you are getting? The fare hike expected to raise rupees 8,000 crores, and this does not help railways as much as it burdens the common man. Railway monetary requirements at present is 60,000 crores for one bullet train, one bullet train project. Another 50,000 crore per year for next 10 years for the ongoing projects. Again, another 40,000 crore for tracks renewal, elimination of unmanned crossings, and construction of RUBs and ROBs. And over and above, 9 lakh crores required for the Diamond Quadrilateral project. From where this money will come? So you have proposed that it will be garnered by four means, including FDI and PPP. Sir, the very announcement of bullet train, which the Honorable Minister thinks that this is the dream of the common man, I respectfully deny and respectfully differ with him, because one of the speakers just mentioned about China and Japan about introducing bullet train. Let me tell you the experience of China and Japan. Bullet train experiments in Japan and China keep running into financial problems. Besides the enormous initial cost, the operating cost may spiral the fares of the train comparable to airfare. So which one the passengers will prefer? So comparing Japan and China, while comparing Japan and China, we must consider their experiences also. So it is all right to dream, but then dream has to have some relation with the reality, and this is the reality. So again, the speed of the trains, the railway minister has mentioned about the increasing the speed of the trains, which will go up to 160 to 200 per kilometer per hour in 9 sectors. Mr. Minister, I may remind you that the heavy density train routes are badly clogged. What you are going to do to declog those 9 sectors? The public-private partnership to fund the connectivity of new areas, new sectors. This is not a new proposal. This proposal was taken up by another former railway minister, in a very enthusiastic manner. But what happened? The PPP has been around for a while, but interest has been very tepid. There were very less takers. So how you are going to make it a reality? This is the question. So the railway budget has mentioned about world-class stations to be built and focus on cleanliness and new facilities, including wake-up calls and destination alerts. So it is good. Corporate hospitality sounds great, but the hooks were put out in the past. Our experience has not been as enthusiastic as the railway minister. Again, another small thing, the ready-to-eat food from reputed brands to be served in the trains. Sir, we, as Member of Parliament, travel by plane, and we experience in the budget airlines the ready-to-eat food they serve, which is very expensive. How do you expect the train, which is a mode of transport for the poor people, for the common people, to expect spend so much of money in their food, in the ready-to-eat food from the renowned brands? Sir, these are certain things which I think the railway minister should rethink and, if possible, take some realistic action on all this. And I appreciate this railway budget has 2014 and 15 proposed 58 new trains, and besides extending 11 existing trains, which has given a number of trains, about 7 trains in the 7 new trains in Northeastern region. I appreciate and congratulate the minister for that. And also 54% hike for 23 rail projects in Northeastern region. So this is again nothing but cosmetic, because the train that you have mentioned about Kamakha Bengaluru Premium Express is already in existence. This train is already in existence. They are catering to the needs of the Northeastern region passengers going to Bengaluru. By putting only or changing the name only, it cannot be a new train. While we are talking about increasing the speed of train to 160 to 200 kilometers per hour in 9 sectors, the faster trains are proposed. But there is no mention of doubling or electrification of railways in Northeastern region. The only project, doubling project, which was proposed in 2013-14 budget, which is New Bongaigaon to Kamakhya via Rangia. This project was announced in the railway budget of 2013-14. But the present budget, the present railway budget, does not have any mention about it. Leave apart the electrification of tracks. So the tracks and the conversion, gauge conversion, in Rangia, Murkongseleng sector, Lamding, Badarpur, Silsar sector, it is over the ages the work is going on. And with this 54% hike in the outlay, I do not think that will cover, although you have mentioned that the Badarpur Lamding Badarpur Silchar will be operative in October 1st. But until and unless it is monitored properly, I do not think it might take more time again. And
yes,
the another project that is about to be completed. You have mentioned certain trains
Kalitaji,
where there is not even
Kalitaji,
railway line.
Please
the
come
railway on. Lines has not been completed, but you want to start a train in what, on that railway line which has not been completed yet. Sir?
So, Kalitaji, is, please conclude.
I am the only speaker speaking now.
Now that is so, correct. You are the only speaker so speaking
you
now.
Must, you must
but another
little,
10, another
you must
10
little more time, sir.
Speakers
me,
from your
let
party.
Me, I'll now concentrate only on my region. The budget is also silent on the connectivity to the state capitals of Kohima, Agartala, or Aizawl. Sir, while mentioning about this, I want to mention two projects. One is new railway line from Amingao to Barpeta Bhaya Hajo was surveyed in as early as 1998. But there is no mention or there is no allocation on the on this line, on this new line in this budget. So I request and I demand that this work on this railway line should be taken up and financial allocation should be made maybe in the supplementary railway budget, or I will request the railway minister to announce this in his reply to the railway budget. So,
yes, sir.
So, just only one more point. The railway line between Bhutan and India from Rangia to the township of Chamruk Zankar, it was also, the survey was conducted in this for construction of this new railway line. But the connectivity between the neighboring country and India could have been improved this after the survey if this has been made a reality.
Okay.
But unfortunately, over the years, railway ministers after railway ministers, this has been raised over and over in the floor
okay.
of this house,
please.
But it has not seen the reality. I request the railway minister to mention about this so that in future, some allocations could be made and it can come to a reality. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Kalitaji. Sri Mansukh Lal Mandavia.
Thank you, sir.
Your party has fixed 10 minutes for you, eh?
Okay, sir.
10 minutes.
Okay. Thank you. Sir, नरेंद्र भाई मोदी की नेतृत्व वाली एनडीए की सरकार का रेलवे का बजट जो सदानंद गौड़ा जी ने रजू किया है उनका समर्थन के लिए मैं खड़ा हुआ हूँ। सर, ये सच है कि हमें विरासत में जो मिला है उनको आधार लेके हमें आगे चलना है। हमारा साथी सदस्य ने कहा कि हमारे जेब में कुछ है नहीं लेकिन मेले में जाना है। ये नरेंद्र मोदी है जो दिन में सपना देखते हैं और जो सपना देखते हैं वो पूरा करने की कोशिश करते हैं और उनकी जिम्मेदारी भी लेते हैं और वो ही रात में ही आप देखते थे इसलिए कुछ कर नहीं पाए थे। और हमारा सदानंद गौड़ा जी ने अपने बजट भाषण में कहा था कि शायद मेरी बजट स्पीच में तालियां कम पड़ेगी लेकिन साल भर तालियां पड़ती रहे ऐसा काम और ऐसा बजट मैं आपके सामने रख रहा हूं जो वास्तविकता के आधार पर है। और इसलिए ये बजट सामान्य जनता की सुख सुविधा को बढ़ाने वाला, किसान को एक नई उम्मीद देने वाला और आधुनिक विश्व में हम सारी दुनिया में जाते हैं, अमेरिका में जाते हैं, चाइना में जाते हैं। मैं जब स्कूल में और कॉलेज में पढ़ता था उस वक्त रेल में जाते थे और वैसा ही डब्बा अभी है। उस वक्त जैसा प्लेटफॉर्म था वैसा ही प्लेटफॉर्म अभी है। उसका मॉडिफिकेशन, उसमें बदलाव, सारी विश्व जो आगे बढ़ रहा है, विश्व के जो आगे बढ़ रहा है उनके सापेक्ष में हमारी रेलवे में कोई परिवर्तन हुआ? मुझे लगता है कि विरासत में हमने वही जूना पुराना ढांचा मिला है, उसमें बहुत कुछ करना है और बहुत कुछ करने की उम्मीद के साथ हमारे मंत्री जी ने ये बजट रजू किया है। वो भी वास्तविकता है कि हमको 30 साल में वैसे ही बजट भाषण हुआ करते थे और उसमें नई नई परियोजना डिक्लेयर हुआ करती थी और परियोजना डिक्लेयर होती थी तब तालियां पड़ती थी। और वो सच्चाई है कि पिछले 30 साल में 676 परियोजना डिक्लेयर की गई और 676 में से भी कितनी पूरी हुई? 676 में से अभी 359 परियोजना अभी पूरी हुई है। योजना डिक्लेयर करने का मतलब क्या है? जो हमारे से हो नहीं सके वो कहने का मतलब क्या है? हमारे नरेंद्र भाई ने और हमारी जो सरकार है इतना ही कहा है जो हो पाएंगे और इतना ही कहेंगे जितना करने के लिए हम कमिटेड है, हमारा कमिटमेंट उनके लिए कायम बने रहेंगे। बिना बड़ी बड़ी बात करने से तालियां तो पड़ेगी, बहुत ही तालियां आपने 10 साल में पड़वाई। तालियां में डिक्लेरेशन हुआ था, 99 परियोजना डिक्लेयर की गई थी, उसमें से केवल 99 परियोजना में से केवल एक परियोजना पूर्ण हो। और फिर विकास की आप बात करें, फिर आप प्रगति की बात करें और फिर कहते हैं कि अभी जो आपने बजट रजू किया है वो मैनिपुलेटेड है, वो बजट में नया कुछ नहीं है। नया कुछ वो है जो वास्तविकता के आधार पर हमने यहाँ पर रखा है। वो भी सच है कि हिंदुस्तान की 125 करोड़ की आबादी जब रेलवे में ट्रैवलिंग करते एक लघु भारत का दर्शन होता है और पहले भुगतान के बाद इतना, तो ऐसी कौन सी व्यवस्था होगी कि जिसमें पैसा का पहला भुगतान कर दे, पहले टिकट खरीदने के लिए पैसे पहले देते हैं, बाद में टिकट परचेज करते हैं, बाद में वो ट्रैवलिंग करते हैं, पहले पैसा मिलने के बाद भी कैसा व्यवस्थापन विरासत में हमने मिला कि जो विरासत के आधार पर हम कुछ नया कर नहीं पा रहे हैं। हम वही सफर ही सफर करते हैं, जनता को सुविधा नहीं मिल रही है। जनता को सुविधा प्राप्त हो, 94 पैसे हमारे जेब में आते हैं। बड़ी बड़ी बात तो हुई, आप मैनेजमेंट के लिए भाषण देने के लिए तो गुजरात तक पहुंच गए, मैनेजमेंट का भाषण दिया, क्या दिया आपने, कैसी रेलवे चलाई? 94 पैसे आपने परिसंचालन में खर्च कर दिया, केवल 6 पैसे। आपको मालूम था जब रेलवे मिनिस्टर जब बात करते हैं संचालन करते हैं तो उसको मालूम ही होता है केवल 6 पैसे डेवलपमेंट के लिए उनके पास बचते हैं, केवल 6 पैसे बचते हैं। और ऐसी ऐसी योजना डिक्लेयर करने का मतलब क्या है? क्या आप वो योजना पूर्ण कर पाएंगे? हमारा सदानंद गौड़ा जी ने, हमारा रेल मंत्री जी ने जो बात आपके आपने सामने रखी है ना, वो धरातल और वास्तविकता के आधार पर बात रखी है, जो हम पूरा करने के वादे के साथ अगले 60 महीने, नरेंद्र मोदी ने अच्छा कहा है, मोदी जी ने कहा है कि आप हमें 60 महीना दीजिए, 60 महीने में हमने जो वादा किया है ना वो वादा हमें पूर्ण करना है। इसलिए हमें कोई ऐसा वादा नहीं करना है जो वास्तविकता के आधार पर नहीं हो, और जो वादा करना है जो वादा हम पूरा कर सके। हम बात करते हैं कि महिलाओं को सुरक्षा प्रदान होनी चाहिए, क्या बात करने से महिलाओं को सुरक्षा प्रदान होगी? हमने ये इनिशिएटिव लेना शुरू किया है, डिब्बे में महिला मुसाफरी करती रहती है, शायद कभी महिला अकेली भी हो सकती है। अरे 17,000 भर्ती की प्रक्रिया शुरू होगी, उसमें से 25% 4,000 महिला कांस्टेबल के रूप में रेलवे में काम करेंगे, रेलवे में मुसाफरी करने वाली महिलाओं को उससे सुरक्षा प्रदान हो सकती है। बात करने से, भाषण करने से महिलाओं को सुरक्षा प्रदान नहीं हो सकती, वो इनिशिएटिव हमारे सदानंद गौड़ा जी ने, हमारे नरेंद्र भाई मोदी के नेतृत्व वाली सरकार ने किया है। और वो उस आधार पर चलेंगे, वो रास्ते पर चलेंगे जो रास्ता हमको विकास की ओर ले चले और जिसके आधार पर हिंदुस्तान की रेलवे एक नया मोड़ पर आए और विश्व की रेलवे के साथ बराबरी कर सके, वैसा रेलवे बजट हमारे रेलवे मंत्री जी ने रजू किया है। हमारे रेलवे मंत्री जी ने अपनी बात में कहा युवाओं को उम्मीद, युवाओं के लिए कुछ करना चाहिए। मैं बार बार, मैं भूतकाल में एक बजट पर चर्चा कर रहा था, मैंने कहा था कैसे डेवलपमेंट हो, हमारे देश में युवा है, युवा के हाथ में कैसे रोजगारी दी जाए, उनके हाथ में काम कैसे दिया जाए। युवा के बारे में बात करने से कुछ नहीं होगा, उनके हाथ में काम होना चाहिए। इसलिए उस वक्त जब नरेंद्र मोदी गुजरात के मुख्यमंत्री थे और युवाओं को स्किल डेवलपमेंट के लिए, मेरा अकेले गुजरात गवर्नमेंट का बजट 800 करोड़ रुपया का था और लास्ट आपका भारत सरकार का बजट केवल 1000 करोड़ रुपया का था। युवाओं के हाथ में काम होना चाहिए, युवाओं के हाथ में स्किल होना चाहिए, और वो बात आगे बढ़ाते हुए हमारे सदानंद गौड़ा जी ने युवाओं को प्रोत्साहित करने के लिए, ये रेलवे है उसमें नई नई टेक्नोलॉजी की आवश्यकता होती है, वो रेलवे है उसका मॉडर्नाइजेशन करना है, उनके लिए टेक्नोलॉजी चाहिए, उनके लिए रिसर्च चाहिए, और ये युवाओं को टेक्नोलॉजी का ज्ञान मिले, हमारे हिंदुस्तान के युवाओं के का कौशल्य का वर्धन हो, इसलिए हिंदुस्तान के युवाओं के लिए दो यूनिवर्सिटी एक नहीं, हिंदुस्तान के युवाओं के लिए एजुकेशन के लिए, हिंदुस्तान का रेलवे का मॉडर्नाइजेशन के लिए, विश्व में जो टेक्नोलॉजी चल रही है ना, हमारे युवाओं को वहां स्टडी करने के लिए जाने की आवश्यकता नहीं है, ये हिंदुस्तान में हमारी विश्वविद्यालय में वो ज्ञान प्राप्त कर सके, डिग्री प्राप्त कर सके और रेलवे में जॉब पा सके, इसलिए दो विश्वविद्यालय की स्थापना की बात हमारा रेलवे मंत्री जी ने कही है, मैं उसको खूब खूब धन्यवाद करता हूँ। साथ साथ में युवा जो मैनेजमेंट में स्टडी करता है, युवा जो टेक्निकल स्टडी करता है, इंजीनियरिंग में स्टडी करता है, वो युवाओं को समर में कुछ काम नहीं होता है, उसको टूर करनी हो टूर में जाते हैं, वैसे युवाओं को इंटर्नशिप के लिए उनकी इंटर्नशिप हो रेलवे में क्यों ना हो, उनके लिए भी व्यवस्था की गई है। मुझे लगता है कि ये बहुत दूरदर्शी वाला कदम है और वो कदम से हमारा युवाओं को नया तकनीकी ज्ञान मिलेगा। और सर जो वरिष्ठ लोग हैं, हैंडीकैप लोग हैं, सीनियर सिटीजन है, उनको केवल आप सस्ती टिकट दे दो, उसकी टिकट में थोड़ा सा लाभ दे दो, उससे काम नहीं होगा। उनकी यातायात सरल हो, उनके यातायात में सुविधा रहे, इसलिए जब वो कोई हैंडीकैप व्यक्ति हो, नागरिक हो, कोई 70-75 उम्र के वाले कोई व्यक्ति हो, कोई नागरिक हो, जब रेलवे प्लेटफॉर्म पर आए तो रेलवे प्लेटफॉर्म पर बाहर से उसको रेलवे के डब्बे तक पहुंचाने के लिए उनके लिए इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल, उनके लिए इलेक्ट्रिक गाड़ी की व्यवस्था हो, जो उसमें बैठकर अपने डिब्बे तक पहुंच सके और कोई हैंडीकैप को कोई मुश्किल ना हो, कोई सीनियर सिटीजन की सुविधा में उसे बढ़ावा मिले। सर अभी तो समय है सर,
2 मिनट
और, सर
2 मिनट।
हमारे यहाँ जो हिंदुस्तान है, इतना बड़ा हिंदुस्तान में सभी ज्ञाति जाति वर्ग समुदाय के लोग रहते हैं, सभी के अपनी अपनी आस्थाएं, अपनी अपनी श्रद्धाएं होती है, वो श्रद्धा अपनी आस्था और श्रद्धा भी पूर्ण हो सके और उसका रिलीजियस टूरिज्म की एक सर्किट डेवलप हो, उनके लिए जो योजना सदानंद गौड़ा जी ने हमारे सामने रखी है, मैं उसको अभिनंदन करता हूँ, उसको धन्यवाद करना चाहता हूँ, इसलिए कि हमारे धार्मिक लोग, ये जो ज्योतिर्लिंग है हमारे देश में चारे कोने में, उनके लिए एक सर्किट, हमारे बौद्ध रिलीजियस टूरिज्म के लिए सर्किट, सिख रिलीजियस टूरिज्म के लिए सर्किट, मुस्लिम रिलीजियस टूरिज्म के लिए सर्किट, ऐसी सर्किट बना के हिंदुस्तान के सभी श्रद्धालु लोग को अपनी श्रद्धा के स्थान पर पहुंचाने के लिए, उनको वंदन करने के लिए, अपनी श्रद्धा को पूर्तता के लिए जो ये व्यवस्था की है ना, मुझे लगता है कि एक बहुत बड़ा और अच्छा कदम है। और सर एक विशेष बात वो है कि रेलवे में किसान के बारे में कभी बात नहीं हुआ करती थी, ये रेलवे बजट में सर, लास्ट टॉकिंग, ये रेलवे बजट में सदानंद गौड़ा जी ने एक विषय रखा है, वो विषय है कि किसान अपने माल, पेरिसेबल जो आइटम है होती है, फ्रूट और वेजिटेबल, वो महानगर तक पहुंचाने के लिए उनके पास कोई व्यवस्था नहीं होती है और फोर ट्रक व्हीकल में वो ले जाते हैं, फोर ट्रक व्हीकल में उसका खर्च ज़्यादा लगता है, और उसमें रेलवे मंत्री जी ने जो रेलवे स्टेशन है, रेलवे स्टेशन पर वातानुकूलित वेयर हाउस बना के किसान अपना फ्रूट और वेजिटेबल पेरिसेबल आइटम अपने स्थान से महानगर तक पहुंचा सके, उसके लिए उसको कम लागत लगे और उसको ज्यादा पैसा मिले, इसलिए जो व्यवस्था की गई है सर, मुझे उसको साच अर्थ में रेलवे मंत्री जी को धन्यवाद देना है और ऐसी तरह से जो सदानंद गौड़ा जी ने बजट पेश किया उनको खूब खूब धन्यवाद करके उनका समर्थन करते हुए मेरी बात पूर्ण।
धन्यवाद 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 श्रीमती ककशन परवीन, नॉट पर्सन, श्रीमती विजिला सत्यनाथ।
Yes. Okay. Honorable Deputy Chairman, sir, after waiting for a week, I rise to find only a very few strength, but I know that my
10 minutes
counterparts are all here to welcome. Honorable Deputy Chairman, sir, I thank, this is my maiden speech, so I would like to give me more minutes so that my expression and the views can be more heard. I thank you for giving me this wonderful opportunity to express my views on the railway budget 2014-15, which was commended by our Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Dr. Purachi Thalivi Amma, as fiscally responsible and very bold. Before beginning my speech, let me shower my beautiful obeisance to this temple of democracy. I am humbled by the fact that I am also one of the legislators who can have a say in policy making out of 120 crore people of India, the great nation. What I am today is because of the unchallenged leader of meritocracy and lady of confidence, Dr. Purachi Thalivi Amma, being the party supremo of All India Anna Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam, to have the honor, I have the honor to belong. She is a very personification of courage, dedication, and motherhood. Her tremendous valor and authority over the party and administering the government has proclaimed her the Iron Lady of India. Here I would like to mention the first speech of our leader of our house, the Honorable Finance Minister, Shri Arun Jaitley Ji, who rightly pointed out that the recent parliamentary election has put an end to family politics. Yes, they have been blown out because of their greediness and selfishness all over India. And exercising our Honorable Chief Minister Dr. Purachi Thalivi Amma's spectacular decision making, she picked me up from a huge cluster of ordinary middle class educated women and placed me as the mayor of Tirunelveli Corporation, a city in the down south of Tamil Nadu. Unsatisfied still, she has decorated me now with the mantle, the member of this august house. I have no words to vocalize my feelings of gratitude, but to bow down my head before her graciousness. I feel proud and privileged to be here in this august house, and especially to stand where my leader, the Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, worshipful Amma, Dr. Purachi Thalivi, stood once glowing with the spirit of service for the people of the nation. Moreover, her mentor and the architect of all Dravidian parties in Tamil Nadu, Aringer Annadurai, a well-known orator, spelt words of action several times in this honorable house. They both electrified their nation by their vibrant speeches on several occasions in this house. First and the foremost, I wish to congratulate the present government's first railway budget, which tries to address many of the past ills of this mammoth public sector organization. To name a few, the recruitment of 4,000 women constables to ensure safety of women passengers, introduction of CCTV to monitor cleanliness activities, retiring room facilities at all stations, food courts in all major stations, online platform and unreserved tickets, combo parking cum platform tickets, facility for 1.2 lakh users can log in simultaneously to book their tickets or welcome by people at large. Sir, this is the time to pay tributes to late Professor Madhu Dandavathe, the first non-Congress railway minister and a nobleman who was a pioneer in introducing 2-inch foam for second-class sleepers coach in his 1977 budget, before it had only wooden sleepers. Our Honorable Chief Minister has commended the Prime Minister of India and the Railway Minister for having practiced transparency in placing before the country the true status of the Indian Railways. And she remarked, and I quote, "What is commendable about this budget is that, having recognized this deep crisis, the railway budget provides a vision for the future." And I end quote. In that line, with only about 6,000 crore surplus, you are trying to create an infrastructure which requires rupees 15,000 crores annually. And everyone knows that we have no options but resorting to taking up of FDIs and PPP model, which is the only way to take the railway forward, for which the previous government was dilly-dallying on. But sir, the fact that you decided to bite the bullet is a brainy act. Finding money has never been a problem for a government as long as it goes on to serve the people. We have lots of examples of Tamil Nadu. When the nutritious meal scheme for students were thought to be launched, there was a stiff resistance from officials citing poor finance level of the state. But because of the persistence of our great leader, the founder leader of All India Anna Dravida Munnetra Kalagam, Dr. MGR, the scheme saw the light of the day. The same was the story when our dynamic Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Dr. Parachi Thalivi Amma, launched the revolutionary scheme like Amma Unavagam, which is today being considered as the Basic Social Welfare Act to be emulated by various state governments and even foreign countries like Egypt. I would like to note that the Amma Unavagam, which gives 1 rupee idli, 3 rupees curd rice, 5 rupees dal with rice, sambar rice, and evening the Amma Unagam supplies to the people chapatis with curry, dal curry. So this is a very, very well known, as well as it has been people friendly, and people
at
all the walks of life,
they
admire this scheme. And I am insisting.
See?
I urge the railway minister that, you know, all the stations in all over Tamil Nadu, the low cost canteens should be open for the benefit of the people at large. And also I want to urge that the Amma water bottle, the mineral water, is now, Amma is providing Amma water bottle in all the bus stations for 10 rupees to all the travelers in the buses. And now I urge the railway minister to reduce the rail neer. Now rail neer is now supplied, it is now supplied for rupees 15 rupees. So now I urge the railway minister to bring down the rail neer cost to 10 rupees. Because if Amma can find the ways and means of doing this, why can't the central government? And I...
Why not Amma water be supplied in the train?
There is a way. Where there is a will, there is a way.
You are
ready? She has given emphasis. I wanted to bring more attention on the railway minister about the transportation organ. I come from the deep south of Tamil Nadu. I come from the southern part, which is the southern tip of Tamil Nadu. So I haven't started my speech.
Your party has given you 10 minutes.
Keeping this mind, our great leader Amma, in her vision to 2023, under the document, some 10 crucial railway projects at an approximate cost of rupees 1 lakh 88.
Srimadhi Vidila, 1 second. Srimadhi Vidila,
Your party has given you 10 minutes and yes. there is and time is interesting like also.
As it is the maiden speech.
It's maiden speech?
Yes, this is my maiden speech.
Then you have completed 10 minutes, take 5 minutes more.
I would like, because I have to mention all
the... Take 5 minutes more, in 15 minutes you complete. Okay. 5 minutes
okay.
more.
Thank you, sir.
5
Thank
minutes
you.
More. Okay.
I will honor the dignity and decorum of this August House.
Thank you very much.
Definitely. And under the Vision 2023 document, some 10 crucial railway projects at an approximate cost of rupees 1,88,400 crores have been identified by her to spur the further economic development. Highlighting the proposed diamond quadrilateral high-speed railway track that could be a game changer, I urge on behalf of our Honorable Chief Minister that this technology, that is the new technology which you have enthused the whole nation by introducing the high-speed bullet trains should be next brought to Chennai, which closely followed Mumbai in the first introduction of rail services in the country. She said, and I quote, the holistic approach proposed to achieve greater urban development integration with railways, which will respond to a long-standing request placed by the state government. And now she has set her eyes upon the Madurai Thoothukudi Industrial Corridor. As early decision on the handover of MRTS network in Chennai to the Chennai Metro Rail Limited should be taken up as insisted by our Honorable Chief Minister. I request the Honorable Railway Minister to take necessary steps to bring divisional headquarters in Tirunelveli, where I belong to. The city has all the requisite infrastructure facilities, be it a river, a perennial river, or proximity to power plants like Kaithar, Tuticorin, and Kudangulam. There is always a popular belief that north progresses, south regresses. This is what expressed by Aringer Anna, one of the pillars of early Dravidian movement. Though situation is not the same today, but you will always like to hear what the justification of my statement. The coaches of all highly profitable southbound trains are very poorly maintained. On June 28, 2014, in a Tirunelveli-bound Nellai superfast train from Chennai, Mr. Charles, a retired spinning mill worker from Vikramasingapuram, was sleeping in the coach S8 in the side lower berth. Around 2:30 a.m., he jumped out with screaming with pain, and he was shouting for help. The reason being that he was severely bitten by a rat, which caused him a bleeding wound.
Oh, Mr. Minister,
and he was,
yes.
after a couple of years,
yes.
he was treated at the Madurai Railway Junction.
I support that.
I sincerely hope
because
the wisdom with which the Honorable Minister is going to act will put an end to this kind of
menace
in the future.
Note of it.
I also urge to put up new coaches in all southbound trains. Also, the first class, the second class, and the third class AC, as well as the non-AC coaches, also should be made available in all the highly profitable. Nowhere there is ticketless travelers in the southbound trains. Nowhere you can find. So all the southbound trains should need more sophisticated, modern, new coaches.
Yes.
And every day on the trains from Chennai to Nagarkoil, Kanyakumari and Tirunelveli, the waitlisted passengers are 4 to 5 times as much as the passengers who are traveling. This is not the case of occasional happening, but all through the year. And this, the number of trains to these places from Chennai must be increased in an urgent manner with modification, upgradation, and sophistication. And I also urge for the allocation of the laying double line between Trichy, Dindukal, and Madurai, Kanyakumari. Already it was said by my counterpart, Mr. Ratnavir. And I would like to draw the attention of this August House to represent the people of all the southern districts of Tirunelveli. 40 crores have been now, Mr. Rengarajan also pointed out that that the gauge conversion of Chengottai Punalur railway gauge is now under very slow progress, because it was only 35 crores was allotted in a phased manner yearly. But it needs a hefty one-time allocation, because when the project is going to end in 2019, it goes up to 800 crores, which will be a very criminal waste of investment. So now I would urge the railway minister to provide one-time hefty allocation.
Now you can
for more allocation, for more machinery, more
now
manpower, so that the shortest distance, now we have to travel to the places of Koyalan, to the places of Ernakulam, we have to take a long route. We have to go to Nagaikoyil, then we go to Trivandrum, and then only we can reach our destinations. But this will be the very shortest route, the Chengottai Punalur meter gauge to broad gauge. Meter gauge is still an underdeveloped nation, so it is a symbol of underdevelopment. So we have to have the
one-time allocation.
We urge the government to give a one-time hefty allocation.
Kanyakumari,
a place of cultural and religious importance, is in the southern tip of India. We, the people of Tamil Nadu, steadfast in respecting sages, poets, freedom fighters of India. I would be very happy that you all will know that the Tamil Nadu government, under the dynamic leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister, has given Vivekananda House of Chennai on a lease of 99 years to the Sri Ramakrishna Mission and rupees 2 crores to set up the Vivekananda Cultural Center. At this time, I have two requests to make. The premium trains introduced from Jaipur to Madurai is extended up to Kanyakumari. You know, there is a monumental Vivekananda rock at Kanyakumari enshrining the sojourn of the Indian saint for gaining spiritual revelation.
Please,
you could give me one more train from Chennai to Kanyakumari during the Vivekananda celebrations, if at all on all the days, you would ever be regarded by the people of the south.
Now please.
And I also wanted to quote here that the Chennai to Madurai route was electrified. And now Madurai to Tirunelveli electrification was completed recently.
Please.
But due to the shortage of electric locos, still diesel locos are used in all the southbound trains, which results in the consumption of more time, more fuel, etc.
Okay.
I turn to the attention regarding the 20 lakh Tamilians settled in Mumbai. I appeal the railway minister to prepone the timings of train number 16339 and 16351 so that
speaker,
it does not reach the station. Only few minutes. Please.
2 minutes. Please, it's already over.
Please, two minutes. I'll complete. And reach the stations like Dindukal, Madurai, Tirunelveli at midnight, 10:30 to 2 p.m. So it is very, very difficult for them to reach their rural destinations. Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir, Indian Railways is one of the biggest sector having the largest number of employees. And I would like to urge, and I cannot afford to forget that less advantage and less privilege.
Okay.
So I make appeal to Honorable Minister to enhance the preference for the people, the disabled, the socially deprived people, and to also recruit more sports persons to give the boost to sports in India.
Okay.
And lastly, quoting our leader, our Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, the finances of railways are in extremely poor shape. And the railway minister has laid bare with disarming candor and honesty. The same honesty we look forward to in putting railway in order so that we would like to hear from the future generation that here is a man who really meant business and turned around the railway in his shoulders. And remind you, the Prime Minister, Mr. Modi ji, that his election campaign has promised the people at all. And I would also quote from a biblical saying, if warriors on foot could tire you, how could you run with the stallions? I wish God speed in all the endeavors of the government. I thank you for having given me this opportunity to express my views. And we will all, against all odds, let us all together, you and I, make this nation a better place for you, for me, and for this entire human race. Thank you. I bow down and
good. Maiden speech was very
thanks.
Good and interesting and encouraging.
Thank you. Good. Thank you. Great.
I think that as far as the trains moving in and around Tamil Nadu, I can get water.
Amma water. Amma water in Tamil Nadu for 10 rupees.
Their share. Public sector yes. Shares in Neyveli Limited Corporation. It was Tamil Nadu government which purchased it from the central government. Yes. So far, we will go to any extent if you ask for the demand.
Yeah. That is a good way. You can give not only for Kerala, for all southern states. Even northern states, why not? Yes? Yeah. And Mr. Minister, what she said about rats. Even I had experience. Okay. I am telling you.
Certainly, I will take care of the things.
See that. Most of the southern trains.
I have received some certain complaints from various.
Rats and. Rat insurance one eye. Okay. Thank you, Sri Alok Tiwari.